Hey, it's Dr. Amanda with Straightsmile Solutions, straightsmilesolutions.com, and today we're going to talk about taking occlusal x-rays to localize canine impactions. And you guys might remember learning the slob rule back in dental school, you know, same lingual opposite buccal, can't talk this morning, to help localize, but I really actually prefer an occlusal x-ray. And for those of you who don't have CBCTs or who, you know, maybe don't want to subject your patient to so much radiation in a larger CBCT, you might just want to go back old school and take occlusal x-ray. So let's talk a little bit about that and why you take it. I take both maxillary and mandibular ones. You can see here, it's a little cut off, but for the maxillary one, you're gonna come down at a 65 degree angle. So you're gonna put the angle, the nose cone going this way at a 65 degree angle to the occlusal plane. And that's gonna give you a view that looks like this if you do have a palatal impacted canine. And for the mandibular, it's actually better just to have them laying down, but you're shooting it down below, you know, under their jaw. And that's gonna be able to lingualize, again, localize lingual or labialize impacted teeth. So yeah, so like I said, this one's gonna usually come down at 65 degrees. I've seen some sources that say 60 degrees. You can use a D or E speed film. Usually it's about 2.5 by 3 inches in size. So they're like almost like a little rectangle, you know, like a little smaller than a deck of cards, these film sizes. But I mean, you could do it with just like a regular PA. I've seen people do that, but you could easily cut off the field. But I mean, it is possible to do it with a regular PA, but just still get these same angulations. If you don't have the occlusal size x-ray, that 2.25 by three, you can do that. Patient needs to bite, you know, on the image. She basically like shoving this whole deck. It's like shoving a deck of cards lengthwise into their mouth, you know? So they need to bite down, but we don't want them like actually biting hard on it because it's gonna make indentations. But I mean, things you can see, you know, sialoliths, tori, position of supernumerary teeth, position of roots or impacted teeth, things like that are really, really helpful. The maxillary one is going to show you again other impacted teeth. You can see the sinus sometimes. So there's a lot of great stuff. So I highly recommend it. It's a very versatile film. And like I said, it's one that you can use. I mean, I think anytime you see a tooth that just looks weird or a supernumerary or a possible impacted tooth, it's always a great idea to localize it so that you know what to expect. Usually in terms of impacted canines, labial ones are easier than lingual ones, at least on the top or buccal ones. For me, it can make a difference on whether or not, especially if I screen this early and I see this at age 6, 7, 8, then I can say like, okay, granted, I don't really refer cases out, but you know, for you guys, if you guys are getting started in ortho, you're going to probably want to refer out anything that's palatal, that's obviously palatal, because it's going to be a lot harder initially. So, all right, thanks so much.